have a feeling that today is going to be a great day. What do you think we all grow? I have a feeling that today is going to be a great day, and guess why? Because today is the year 2001. I'm 23 years old, and I have just graduated from my master's degree in journalism. And yes, I am so ready to get a job, a power job, in a television network and produce the best stories the history of journalism has ever seen. I'm ready to take over the world. But you know what? The world had a very different plan for me. You see, the year 2001 marks the worst economic crisis in my home country, Argentina. And things, as I was about to graduate, start getting tougher and tougher. There were riots in the street, people getting killed, and we had 5 presidents in 10 days. Real story. So as I graduated, unemployment hit 25%, and the opportunities and the prospects for a recent graduate like me were not great. I remember I tuned in the TV and I watched a game show that was airing at the time in Argentina that was called Human Resources, Recursos Humanos. It's quite a weird name for a game show, right? But because there was an explanation. While in the rest of the world, game shows, contestants, competed for cash prizes, in human resources, they competed for cashier jobs at a supermarket. So that was the reality back then. And there were thousands of contestants, because you know what? If you got that job as a cashier at the supermarket, you were very lucky, because you could feed your family. So that was the situation. How many of you have ever been unemployed? I'm sure I'm not the only one. Well, anyone who has been unemployed knows that you go through phases. Phase number one, pure positivism. This could be the great thing that ever happened to me. I have free time. I can catch up with my family, my reading. Okay, that phase for me lasted like 1 week. Because the rest of the people had things to do, and I had time. So it didn't work. Phase number two was I became a resume sending machine. Every day, tracking the radio stations, the TV stations, the journalists, sending pitches to ideas. This got me a 10 in productivity, but a 0 in results. So after a few months on phase two, I went to phase three. And I became the pajama queen. So I would wake up, get in front of the computer, log into a job seeker website, eat, have my lunch, my breakfast, my dinner, go to bed, and then repeat everything in my pajamas. And while that sounds funny today, really, after months of doing that, it does hurt you. It hurts your self-esteem. And you really start to believe, it's easy to get confused, and you start to believe that this lack of results, the lack of interest that you have from the world, is a reflection of your worth as a professional or even as a person. And that really can break your heart and your self-esteem. So that's where I was in the year 2001, until I got a phone call from my friend Maria. My friend Maria, she's amazing. She graduated with me same year, and she got a real job. She was working in a public relations firm, super fancy, and she was calling me because they were coordinating a summit on political communications with speakers from all around the world. And she told me, Gabby, I have a job for you. And I said, wow, this is going to be amazing, because finally, I can get to do what I studied for. I get to interview global leaders, write the press releases, do important stuff. That was great. But Maria told me, no, Gabby, we need a helper. I need you to hand out flyers. I need you to move the chairs. And I need you to wave at people when they come and show them their seat. Okay, would you do that? And she was my friend. And I said, okay, I will do that. And she said, wait, there's one more thing. We don't have money to pay you. Would you still help me? And I said, okay, we've been friends, so I'll be there. I'll help you out. And the moment I hung up, I realized that everybody else that graduated with us, and even people from prior years, were going to be there. And they were working either in media companies, or they were working in corporate jobs, global companies, and I would be the one greeting them, handing them out the flyers, moving the chairs. And at that moment, I felt, this is the proof that I am a total failure. People with my same age, same opportunities, are going to be there attending the conference, and I'm going to be there moving the chairs, giving out flyers. And while I was having this pity party in my head, the phone rang again. And this time it was my mom, Cristina. Just what I needed, Mama Cristina. Let me show you a picture of Mama Cristina. There you have it. So, Mama Cristina, let me tell you about her. She is like the Erin Brockovich of Argentina. minus the deep cleavage dresses. Come on, no, Mama Cristina, she doesn't wear that. But she's a lawyer. She has this larger than life personality, deep voice, and she doesn't take crap from anybody. So she calls me, ¿Qué está pasando, Gabriela? Oh, my mom. Oh, the world is so unfair. I studied so hard, and now the flyers, and I'm a failure, la, la, la. And she told me, are you crazy? And I'm saying, Mommy, I think I'm going to cancel. It's too much. Are you crazy? You don't have a job, and you're canceling a job? This doesn't make any sense, Gabriela. And I said, okay, wait, wait. No, it's not like that. They're not paying me. So it's not like it's going to make any difference. And she said, you better listen very carefully to me, Gabriela. Me vas a escuchar muy bien, hija. This is what you're going to do tomorrow. Tomorrow, you're going to put on your best clothes. You're going to put some red lipstick. And you're going to smile like they are paying you $1 million per minute. You bring your A game because you never know when opportunity will knock on your door. And I, being the obedient daughter that I am, I said, yeah, Mommy. So the following day, I put on my best clothes, I put on the lipstick, I go to the event, and with a big smile, I move the chairs with great attitude, I hand out the flyers with great attitude, show the way with great attitude, and while I was doing all my chores, my friend Maria comes back again, and she says, Gabby, she's very stressed, Gabby, we have an emergency. What happened? The translator canceled last minute, and I have the American delegation of professors from George Washington University here, and nobody can translate. Could you please help me? Sure, I drop the chair, kept smiling, more lipstick. And I went to translate for the delegation of professors. So long story short, they were so happy with my work that this translation job translated into a telework job that actually was paid in dollars. So they were sending me assignments. And 1 year later, when one of these professors had a job opening in his PR firm, guess who was first in line to have that offer? Yours truly. So in 1 year, I went from unemployed in Buenos Aires to public relations executive in Washington, D.C., the nation's capital. So I still remember when I got the news. When I got that email, we hugged my mother, we cried, and she told me, Ahora vas a ver que nunca más te va a faltar el trabajo. And she was right. But from that day on, you know, I never take an opportunity for granted because I know what it feels like not to have any opportunity in your horizon. So that was the lesson that I learned when I was 23 years old. And in a few words is, don't play it safe, because imagine what would have happened if I had played it safe and canceled that day. And it's a lesson that I keep with me even to this day. I didn't play it safe when I quit my news anchor job to start my own television show that started in a carpet warehouse, and now it's in all the country, and we just won an Emmy Award. So we're not playing it safe. And I'm gonna be honest with you. I'm not planning to play it safe in my next business move. Later this year, in fourth quarter, I was so tired of listening that there were no things, nothing for Latinas in technology, nothing going on in Silicon Valley for Latinos, that we are going to launch the first bilingual mobile app dedicated to co-creating events and planning events with a Latino heart. So it's gonna be called, it's Celebrastic, Celebration and Fantastic. So you can go to celebrastic.com and sign up for the beta version. I could really use the feedback from all these tech-savvy Latinas for our beta version. But after this shameless plug, I wanna go back to the core message, which is don't play it safe. I learned it. It took me a while. I was 23 years old. I was so scared. I was so insecure. I felt like, you know, the disapproval of my friends was I don't even know what it was, why it was so important. So really, don't play it safe, because playing it safe could be the riskiest move you can ever make. So go live your dream right now. Thank you very much.